fans, welcome to Tampa, Florida, the beautiful a la carte pavilion. Tonight, it's RFC 31 New Breed. We're here to guarantee you an exciting championship fight night from the longest running pro MMA event in the entire Southeast. We're going to have the 69 Slam Girls from Australia. Prince Fielder from Major League Baseball. The legend himself, Shaquille O'Neal, will be in the house. We have fans coming from everywhere to watch this event tonight. And Nick, it's just because they keep setting the standard higher and higher. You do not want to miss this great event. Come see our celebrity friends and come see some knockouts and submissions from the very best. It's professional fight night. RFC 31 New Breed starts now. Coming up next, it's Tito Rodriguez and Justo Martinez. 135 pounds of fast and furious action is about to clash.
Well, you said it, Benny. These guys are all over the cage, up, down, left, right. 135 pounds, a very exciting weight class, and these two guys are in shape, ready to go.
This weight class, they never get tired. They're always exciting. Sometimes we see them go to the distance, but it's never for a dull moment. I can't wait to see how this one plays out here right now, RFC 31.
Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
His opponent fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks. He weighed in at 135 pounds, a veteran of two professional bouts. His fighting style is MMA, representing Team Darkseid from Ruskin, Florida. Here is Annabelle Rodriguez. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the red trunks with the black and white trim. He weighed in at 135 and a quarter pounds. His professional record, one win, one loss. He fights freestyle, representing Champions MMA from Bradenton, Florida. Here is Justo Martinez.
What's up, folks? It's Big Boy here at RFC 31. I'm standing with Justo Martinez. Awesome amateur fighter, 135 pounds, coming out of Bradenton, Florida, Champions MMA. He's going to be fighting Tito Rodriguez tomorrow night at RFC 31. Justo, big shot at this to make a name here in the RFC. What's your plans tomorrow night?
Just fight. That's it.
Fight. So have you prepared like any different in your training camps? Any special partners you want to thank? Any sponsors?
No, just thanks to RFC. That's it.
The RFC. Listen up, not much to say, a man of less words, I would say. Justo Martinez, RFC 31, tomorrow night.
Oh, see, can you see by the dawn early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's glass gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, for the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Flag was still
will be right back. Watching XPTV Sports.
Woo! Here we are back at the RFC Real Fighting Championships a la carte pavilion. Sold out crowd. What a crowd it is. We have a lot of celebrities in the house tonight. Shaquille O'Neal, speaking of many of them, Prince Fielders, Doug Martin, and the list goes on. And you can see how the crowd is all red for this one. I don't think there's an empty seat in the house. It was a sold-out crowd tonight, and everyone's very excited to be here. I'm Cage Sai with our play-by-play analyst, Nick Alexander. And as we go into this, it's round one. Tell us a little bit about who is coming up here and what we're going to expect.
All right. Thank you, DK. We got a feature bout here with Justo Martinez versus Anibal Rodriguez. And a good shot of our ring card girl here, giving us the all-important round number one card. So, hopefully we can get this fight going here pretty darn quick here, DK. Right there, a real good shot of Anibal Rodriguez jumping in the cage, getting in Justo's face. And you got Anibal Rodriguez in the red gloves and Justo Martinez in the blue gloves. And these two are really talking a lot of smack in the first, during the weigh-in. And even earlier, DK, they I think for whatever reason have no love loss. It could be a Latino thing. It could be a weight class thing. It could be a divisional thing. We're not sure, but they are amped up to get going here, DK. You got a good look at Justo Martinez right there. Really the thicker of the two. And but Anibal very, very aggressive, and Justo coming with an overhand right. Anibal goes for a kick, gets knocked down. Justo on his back. Unbelievable transition. Look at that. He's grabbing his leg. He's starting to twist out and right back into position. Justo goes, dives under, takes him down. Unbelievable action, DK. These two are going toe-to-toe like a little ball going around this cage, DK. There, amazing action. The crowd is loving it. And you got a good shot of Justo taking Anibal's back again here and looking for a rear naked choke. He's got a body triangle locked in. Justo Martinez has the body triangle. He's looking for the choke. He's starting to soften up his man with some strikes. And, I don't know if you've been in one of those, but a body triangle could submit you by itself, done properly and with enough pressure. That is horrible. He's at least starting to suck his wind, take the life out of Anibal from holding that body triangle. So this is a great position for Justo Martinez on his back here with the body triangle locked in, and he's still, they're fighting for position, who can get the hands in deeper at that point. Anibal's doing the right thing. He's really hand fighting. He's keeping Justo from getting anything deeper. Justo has to switch to the other side and is starting to sink in a body triangle from the other side. Unbelievable transitions from Justo Martinez. This man is transitioning nicely all around the cage and has found himself in a very, very beneficial spot for this round. We've spent almost a minute in this position, DK, and that is tiring stuff. So Justo doing really, really good. He's not able to get anywhere near the rear naked choke, but he is keeping dominant control of this action. And wow, nice. Anibal is starting to get out of this. Justo tries to take his back. They stand up, knee strike, heavy right. They get, wow, heavy left hand from Justo. Anibal is hurt. He looks like he's recovering a little bit. Justo is all over him, though, man. Anibal will not give up. He's tough as they come, DK. But Justo is just transitioning beautifully from submission attempt to takedown to strikes, right? Mixing it up very nicely. It's one thing you can say about these smaller fighters, 135-pound fighters, DK, is they really transition nicely all over the cage. And heavy strike from Justo, answered back from Anibal. And these two have not wasting all. What a beautiful combination landed by Justo, left and right. And Justo dives in for the legs, looking to get another takedown on Anibal. And I'm telling you, we have seen more action in these 3 minutes, DK, than we have seen in a lot of fights the entire fight. So it's a pleasure to call these two going toe-to-toe and all over in a ball. And the whole nine, Justo is just
all over Anibal, though. He's not giving him even a second of rest. Even when he Anibal's doing the right thing, Jusso transitions to a new position that is making it difficult for him, which you can see just the schooling of Jusso is just very clean. He does not mess around when it comes to his grappling, and Anibal has to be very, very careful here. He's about to get choked out if he's not careful. Again, with the body triangle for Jusso Martinez, this time he has the arms in a little bit deeper than he did before. So if he can really get a good squeeze off here, he could need to get that arm underneath the jawline of Anibal, who is doing a nice job getting right back into guard. And let's see if Jusso has much of a guard to go with the other grappling skills of his. He got past, but he gets right back to his knees. And this time Anibal is not giving him a chance, so maybe he's starting to turn tides here. Nice knee strike, and he's got a grounded fighter there, so he has to be very careful. We're getting a referee stoppage. What has happened is, in the rules, you cannot knee strike a fighter to the head if he's grounded. What made him grounded was he was touching the ground with his hand, and as soon as that hand touched the ground, Anibal was not allowed to knee strike him to the head. He could knee strike to the body, but not the head. And man, DK, I hope this is not the end of this fight, because we were treated to 3-4 minutes of just intense, wonderful action. You know, I know all the fans in the arena were ecstatic. I was ecstatic. You were ecstatic. Everybody was real happy with the fight that was being produced here. These two were matched up specifically for their attributes, and they were showing what they could do. We're getting a look there at Jusso. Hopefully he's going to be okay to continue. You got Anibal there. You can see that he's been in a tough fight for 3-4 minutes there. And Jusso is still looking a little fuzzy. We got the doctor actually looking at him, making sure he's able to continue. And, for all of our sakes, let's hope he is. He's not getting up too quickly, however, DK. How did you have it?
It's how some of these live shows are. You're right here cage side watching this thing one-on-one. And again, we're waiting for him to make a move. They're giving him time to recover from it, but it doesn't seem like that's going to happen. And the doctor is checking his vitals there to make sure he's not unconscious and he's able to talk and his eyes look right. And he's really taking a look at him. But I think the towel is going to be thrown in here. I don't know if he's going to let him go on. It's a shame. Because really, like you said, Jusso, man, some of the punches and some of the things he was able to land was just amazing. And it was a lot of intense action that happened there within that first 4 minutes of this fight, like you said.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Jusso, he got to his feet, doesn't look too wobbly, but I don't think they're going to let him fight anymore. I think maybe that knee strike was just too devastating for him to continue safely. I think that's probably what it's coming down to. So, Jusso was putting in a great performance, and, we're going to get a ring announcement here.
Yeah, it seems like he's getting ready. He's got the cards coming up to him. It's inevitable who won this, at least who has to win it, because he can't go on any further. I don't think either fighter likes to lose a fight this way or have a fight stopped this way. They wanted to prove themselves in the cage and have that shown to be the conclusion of it. Not something that was technical. Here's a replay on it. I think at the XPTV replay, we're going to see it in slow-mo, so we can be able to see the action that actually stopped this thing, and you can see how they're going through it. Maybe you can talk this through us a little bit, Nick. I think this is the fast part of it, and then we're going to slow it down for the replay.
Yeah, absolutely. Anibal was starting to turn it on a little bit. He was getting Jusso in a good position, and he lands a good knee strike. Very, very legal knee strike, but Jusso realized it and touched the ground there. So what we're going to see is a real slow. So you can see that Anibal is starting to get some strikes landed. He's going to pass the guard of Jusso. Jusso's going to do a smart thing here, and he's going to underhook and get to his knees. But Anibal transitions and goes for, head control. Head and arm control, and maybe even looking for a choke. And as soon as Jusso stands up, Anibal has a legal right to knee him to the head, which he does right here. Bang, nice knee strike. Clean. Jusso touches.
We'll be right back.
Martinez.
Hey guys, I'm with your winner, Justo Martinez, and nobody wants to win by DQ, so tell the fans out here what you're feeling right now.
Nothing. There's nothing to say.
Train hard for a fight. It was a great fight. You had awesome back control, really good rhythm, and he was a scrappy guy to fight with.
I'm sorry, Tito.
Tell you what, just for you guys, he's not wanting to talk, but hearing them two together right now, they're talking about let's do it again if the RFC will have it. A great rematch is set up. Accidental DQ. Great sportsmanship. We'll let him go to the locker room, but that was a great start to tonight's RFC 31.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Fight and a good start to the RFC 31, but kind of a crazy finish.
It was, you know, it was really turned into a really good fight, and unfortunately we had an illegal knee there, and that, you know, that happens. It's hard for a fighter. You're in the middle of a fight, it gets heated. You can't just, you know, stop things sometimes, and unfortunate.
I tell you, it wasn't intentional by any means, and they were both sorry that it happened. They both want a rematch, so I'm excited to see that.
Yeah, I'd like to see a rematch of those two. It really was turned into a good fight. Justo had his back a couple times. The animal was able to escape, and it was really going to be good.
We'll see him again in the future, I'm sure. RFC 31, new breed.
Hey, how's it going? I'm here at the MMA fights in Tampa. I just wanted to ask this sexy man right here how he's enjoying the fights. What do you think?
They're pretty exciting. I think the RFC puts together great matchups, and the crowd's going crazy all night long.
I think it's because of you. They're going crazy for you. What do you think?
I appreciate that, but maybe they're looking in the back where you're sitting. They see you.
I know these fighters are doing a really good job tonight. Let's give them a round of applause.
Marcus Jones, former professional fighter, Super Bowl winner, a good friend. We haven't seen each other in a while. It's great to see you at the fights again tonight, man.
You know, it's great to be back. You know, this is one of the places where I got my starts. You know, I don't remember much when I was here because I lost my first fight here. But it's a great atmosphere. The people enjoy the sport. I mean, this is where you can get your start. If you're in Tampa, you want to fight for the RFC.
Well, and you did, and it was a lot of fun to watch you, and you're back to watch somebody else now. Tell the fans at home why you're here tonight.
I'm here tonight to watch Ron Hudat. He's a really good friend of mine. I mean, we fought on a couple cards together, and I tell you, he's an unbelievable fighter. But at the heart of it all, he's an unbelievable person. He's just a really good friend. I look forward to seeing him do well tonight.
Well, you know, like in this sport, you develop a lot of friendships, even if they're on other teams.
Yeah.
And you meet people from around the way, and it's kind of cool to build those relationships.
Oh, it definitely is. Like I said, he's a good guy, man. I want him to do so well. You know, don't take a picture of me when he's fighting because I'm going to probably have my face covered because I want him to do so well. But it's a great event tonight, man. Look around. It's electric here. You can't beat this.
And it's going to be an awesome title fight. And I know you're going to predict him to win, but what do you think? Is he going to submit?
No, he's going to knock him out first round.
Knockout in the first round. Marcus calls it. That fight's coming right up next here at RFC 31.
Here we go. Doug Martin, ladies and gentlemen. All right, go. Former defensive end for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and MMA fighter, Marcus Jones. Marcus Jones, ladies and gentlemen. Also from the world of MMA, a former RFC champion, longtime MMA fighter, Edson Berto.
RFC event. We can't wait for the next one. On behalf of XPTV Sports and the RFC, I'm Benjamin Glossop alongside Nick Alexander. We'll see you at the next one.
I'm motivated, might be tough when you know you hate it. Then you hop in that whip, throw a CD on, cause the radio's overrated. Every day I got stuff to do, working hard, it ain't nothing new. Always thinking about dreams, but I just hope that they're coming true. If you got plans, better call them on, cause my flow hotter than a mall of talk.
if you're rich, but you're acting poor, go to a mattress store because you all is up. You gotta be hard for reality. Got the heart of a lion come and battle me. Ever since I was little, I was on another level, like I was literally born on a balcony. I do this all for my family, and I know these haters can't stand me. They want blazing clips, they want chains and whips, but that's not what gets you no Grammy. Living every day like my B-Day. Drink it up, I can't see straight. Life is a game and I live for the moment, cause ain't nobody get no replay, and I'm done. I do this for my city and the people riding with me from Pinellas County. Came a long way from walking the hallways. I moved to Norway and working found me. Up at a factory, working and stacking cheese. Family was backing me, I was leaving. Could never afford to rhyme, now with recording time, I can tell you what I believe in.
I'm on another level, swear we're not the same. It's been a long road, look how far I came. Now everywhere I go, people know my name. Big women blowing up my phone, what you want from me?
Top of my game right now. Better move out of my way right now. Let these haters keep talking about me, cause I'm the one that gets paid right now. I'm on top of my game right now. Better move out of my way right now. Let these haters keep talking about me, cause I'm the